go somewhere or to do something. It means to call for, listen, or ask to go to some place or gathering. Somebody say invitation. Now the Bible says that they wanted the chief room. A room is a space that can be occupied or where something can be done. Look at somebody. Say, God is making room. He's making room. There's another prescription that says, your gift, here we go, will make room for you and bring you before great men. I come to tell somebody today that God is saying your gift is creating room just for you. Your gift, your abilities, your talent, your anointing, your character, and your personality is creating a space that can only be stepped into you by you. Look at your neighbor and say, you might be in my seat. Anytime you receive something by RSVP, that means you got special permission to be at this event. If you don't have the proper identification to verify the fact that you're supposed to be there, you can lose your ability to attend that place. And God said, I'm about to separate and distinguish between those who just put themselves in a position and for those who I want to be there all the time. Look at your neighbor and say, once again, I'm telling you, you might be in my seat. Concert, if you will notice on your ticket stub, that they will give you a row, they will give you a seat, they will give you everything you need to know your position. Yeah. And the ticket is what validates the fact that this is your seat, this is exactly where you're supposed to be. Now, even though if someone else is occupying that seat before you get there, when you get there, if you got your receipt, if you got your ticket, I don't care who's sitting there, look at somebody say, that's my seat. Room. They want the best room. Room is opportunity. Say that. Room is an opportunity or a place for something to happen. Did you hear what I just said? A room is an opportunity or a place for something to happen. Let me say it again. A room is an opportunity or a place. It's a specific place where something is designated to happen. And so if God has sent out an invitation and he sent you an invitation, there's a room that's already ready for you to get there. Huh? I don't have nobody that's hearing what I'm saying today. But I'm telling you, if God has already opened the door for you, he's just waiting on you to show up. And whenever you show up, it's the people that's going to have to scoot over. Look at your name. You might be in my seat. I know you're comfortable. I know you like sitting here. But if God wants me there, you got to get up. You got to get up. You got to get up. Because God said 2014 is a year of divine opportunities. God said, I'm creating rooms and I'm opening the doors to those rooms. See, let me help you out. You'll be shouting when we say God's about to open the doors, but the door is only giving you access to the room. Somebody say, wonder what's in the room. Once you get through the door, that's the only way to find out what's in the room. Now when I get access to the door, when I walk through the door and get in the room, most of the time there will be seating. And each seat has been ordained by God to the person that he invited. Look at the neighbors again and say, get out of my seat, get out of my seat. I don't want no controversy. I'm not trying to argue with you. But I got my ticket. I got my reservation. This is my seat and this is where God told me to. If you have ever been to an event and some person, some rude person, or sometimes they may have not known, or sometimes they may think because you're running late, you weren't going to show up. preach, boy. You know, some of us, we'd be a little behind schedule. And so people begin to start sitting in your seat because they assume you're not coming. But tell somebody the devil is lying. Tell them I might be late, but I'm coming. Man, what am I saying? In other words, the business that you supposed to have been open 3 years ago is late, but it's still coming. So the building and the finances and the economic needs are already met. Look at somebody say, I'm over here. Listen, so I want to help all of you out. That's been feeling overlooked. That's been feeling, glory to God, disregarded. God said you might be late, but you still got the invitation. Listen now. Listen. He says they chose out, according to the Bible, the chief rooms. Saying to them, when thou art bidden or invited of any man, here it is, to a wedding. Yes. So it's not just any event, it's a wedding. Yeah. It's the merging of things. It's divine covenant. Yeah. Preach for it's divine connection. Yeah. And so some invitations, glory to God, they are illegal until the right people show up. Yeah. I'm prophesying better than you shall. I need you to hear the undercurrent of what I'm saying. God said this is a year of divine covenants and connections. The Bible says that it was an invitation to the wedding. A wedding is the merging of two families. It's the connection of bloodlines. What God has joined together, let no man put aside. Let me pray you. When God has something for you, can't nobody else get it. That's yours. Something. By divine connection, God is the one joining them together. And so dry your ears, wipe your eyes, because God said nobody can get what I have ordained for you. Yeah. It was a wedding. So the husband that God got for you, for the wife that God got for you, whatever divine connection that God got for you, it is already in a position to be released. He's just waiting on your appearance. And I told you there is something that's called a geographical grid. It is a place in the earth that already has your DNA. And once you find that position, the earth begins to respond because you showed up. Things begin to shift to accommodate your personality. Things begin to shift to accommodate your presence. Because once you get there, the earth recognizes you because God said, I already got you registered. Once you get in the place in the position where God wants you, watch how prosperity begin to blossom. Because provision is God provided before time. Let me release you, baby girl. God already met your need before you were ever born. That's what provision is. God didn't just see this coming on the scene. The Bible says he chose us in him before the foundation, oh God, of the world. He told Jeremiah, I knew you before. Somebody shout before. Before you was in your mother's womb, I knew you. Before your mother and your daddy met in the back of an 84 Cutlass. God said, I already knew who you were. Accident, God said, I invited you to the earth. Yeah. So let's get rid of the spirit of suicide now. You're supposed to be here. I don't care how you showed up. God said, I invited you to the earth before you ever manifested in time. Look at the neighbor and say, I pray the spirit of suicide of your life because you're supposed to be here. Check the list again. I'm on there. I'm on there. I'm on there. I suppose.